just lied and said that Jesus Christ is a liar.
Of the Bible.
I don't care where from.
Of the Bible.
Easter is a counterfeit Christ.
Can I prove it to you?
Jesus no, of the Bible you can't is a liar? Because it's false. Try, okay, but you will not prove
it. I'll prove it to you. Jesus of the Bible is a liar. How?
I told you without the phone what it says. You then brought up the phone and it actually almost word for word said what I said without any exegesis. Now you disagree with my exegesis, but I'm letting you know that my exegesis is not mine alone. It is the entirety of Christendom, the body of Christ as it stands today. Believe what I am saying.
Quote me, who says that?
I just said it, and
which scholar says
doctrine?
That John the Baptist was the last prophet?
What?
Which scholar says that John the Baptist was
any
the last prophet?
Any Bible commentary that you want to go to?
Because you show me.
You've got the Bible open in front of you.
You don't have Bible with you?
You've got the Bible.
You don't have a Bible.
You're playing games.
You don't have Bible with you.
You're playing games.
You don't have Bible with you.
Are you playing? Yes, I have my phone with
stop
me.
Panicking.
Are you
stop panicking.
I'm not panicking.
Let's have a dialogue.
Okay. Right. Let me. Okay. This is
you
my.
You're talking now. It's now my time. Let me talk.
Who said so?
You already talked.
I
let you speak.
I was still
continuing. So when I'm talking, when you finish.
My point is this: I don't have to accept your exegesis of my scripture and the doctrine that my church has taught for ever. No one's ever questioned that. They probably did, but the church standard is that after John, because Jesus Christ himself said the word. So if I seem a little bit irritated, it's because you're attacking the argument as if it's mine alone, but it is the church. And when you say who said so, I just told you the church said so, like within all of that stuff, any commentary. And also there's Matthew 11, 12 that you haven't got to, which is an extended version of Luke's recounting of that conversation.
Okay,
so, okay.
You're done, yeah?
Yes.
So now your point, the initial point was where I approached you today, because you told Ali Dawa and you make a claim that John the Baptist was the last prophet, and there's no prophet after John the Baptist. So I approached you today and I said you are wrong, right?
What did I say?
Let me say what I said first, yeah? I say you are wrong, why? Because in the book of Acts we learn there were three people who were called prophets.
I told you that Paul was telling people to pray for prophecy. Excellent.
Just calm down here, calm down here. So here it says about the prophets. Judas called Barnabas. Okay. Silas and Judas, they were also prophets. So does Acts 15 verse 32 says, and Judas and Silas, who were themselves prophets,
did they become prophets after John the Baptist was beheaded? Does it say so?
It's in Book of Acts.
In the book of Acts, does it tell you the point at which they became prophets?
So you are saying these people were
before
John the Baptist?
I'm just asking you a question.
No, you should know that. You should know that.
I do know it, and that's why I'm asking you to illustrate a point.
No, you say John the Baptist is the last prophet.
Judas
and Silas were before John the Baptist.
Brilliant.
You have to prove
is
that.
It my turn? I don't have to prove that. No, I don't. I'm not your dimmy. If you're a Muslim, I don't know. The point is this. Jesus himself, with his own mouth, in two different accounts in the Bible, said these words. Up until John, meaning the baptizer. Up until John, the law and the prophets.
Yes.
The word until indicates that after that is something different.
So he lied, obviously.
Wait. Jesus lied.
Yeah, okay.
You're an embarrassment.
Jesus, the Bible lied.
You're an embarrassment.
Well, I can prove it to you. Many places he lied, according to the Bible. Can I prove it to you?
Prove me from the Quran, which says he's sinless.
Oh, through your Bible. Through your Bible, I'm going to prove
my
it to you.
My Bible.
Through your Bible, because you believe in the Bible. We believe in Jesus.
No, you don't.
No,
no, no, you're on your own here. You're calling Jesus a liar on camera.
No,
you're embarrassing
Jesus of the
yourself.
Bible is a liar. I can prove it to you, yes,
right,
of course.
Okay.
That's one side.
Well, you'll understand that I'm calling you a liar personally.
What did you lie?
You just lied and said that Jesus Christ is a liar.
Of the Bible.
I don't care where from.
Of the Bible.
Easter is a counterfeit Christ.
Can I prove it to you? Jesus
no,
of the Bible
you can't
is a liar.
Because it's false. Try,
okay,
but you
okay,
will
okay,
not prove
okay,
it.
I'll prove it to you. Jesus of the Bible
sure
is a liar.
Will.
How? Because we don't believe Jesus. That's the point.
You don't believe in Jesus.
We don't believe that
Jesus.
You don't
believe
Jesus.
You
don't believe that
Jesus,
Jesus,
don't
Jesus is
Jesus.
Esau, of course.
You don't
okay, I'm going to show you to you.
I mean, the arrogance is astounding.
Truth is arrogant by nature.
No, not
yeah.
at all.
Okay, Jesus is talking to Nicodemus
sure.
In John chapter 3.
Yep.
What did he say? in chapter 3, verse 13, he says, Nicodemus, no one has ascended into heaven, but he who descended from heaven, the Son of Man.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Jesus is referencing himself as the Son of Man.
No, what does it mean, whole thing? No
the
one
Son
ascended.
I'm going to tell you. The Son of Man is a reference to, I believe it's the book of Daniel. And in the book of Daniel, or it could be Ezekiel, anyway, in the Old Testament, the Son of Man is referenced as coming on clouds of glory with the Ancient of Days. So it's a duality of God. The Ancient of Days is the Father, and the Son of Man is, it doesn't literally mean the Son of a Man, because we know that Christ has no
Father.
He's talking
about himself.
Yes, he is the Son
of
Man.
What is he saying? No one has ascended into
Christ
heaven.
Christ had yet to ascend.
No one has ascended into heaven.
You tell me someone who has.
Yes, that's what I'm going to say. Elijah.
Okay.
Elijah ascended to heaven before that.
Right.
So he's lying.
He's not lying.
Yes, Elijah did ascend into heaven. Do you agree that or not?
Wait, I'm going to read the verse myself.
Chapter 3, verse 13. That proves that Jesus of the Bible is a liar.
Jesus is not a liar in any...
Of the Bible. Jesus of the Bible.
No, I understand what you're saying, but Jesus
is... He is honored in this world and in the hereafter.
I'm proving it. You're not proving
Quran
it.
Quran says...
Stop speaking while I look at the reference. Do you want to just bamboozle me?
Go on.
Excellent.
Quran says, Isa ibn Maryama, Wajiha for dunya wal akhirah. Isa, Jesus, son of Mary. To the camera.
I know, but this is a Christian channel.
Yeah, they should be guided as well. I'm trying to guide them.
Guided them in a language they
don't
guidance.
Understand. I'm translating it now.
Sure.
Jesus, son of Mary, honored in this world and the hereafter, and though among those nearer to God. That's what we think Jesus was. But the Bible degraded him. Bible disrespect him by saying something which was a lie. And Jesus could never lie, but Bible say he was a liar. So that's why this is one of the reasons rejecting the Bible.
Excellent. While I'm looking for this, when Jesus in the Quran says, blessed is the day I die, and blessed is... No, I won't just answer it. Please, Abbas, stop trying to...
Answer this first.
Abbas, I'm looking
Why
for...
Why are you Christians always hiding behind the skirt
Abbas,
of Islam? Why?
Why are you scared
from your Bible.
For me now to put
my
your
own
time.
I will answer
no,
in my own
No, you
time.
Won't.
I will.
Abbas,
Wallahi,
stop the...
Anything
what
you can
Allah
ask
me. Mean?
Wallahi means I believe in Allah.
I know exactly
by Allah.
What
by
it
Allah.
Means. It means nothing to me. Oh, you again? That's excellent.
To me, it means
I thought Allah.
You
left.
When did you
left? I don't know. I was
you're
told
not lying.
That you
No, you are lying as well.
No, no. I,
you lie on the
I
camera. When did you left
lying.
Us now? When
did you left us now? We asked you last week, are you still a Muslim? And you went like this.
What did I say?
You did this.
What did I say? I'm joking. Did I say I'm joking? Oh, you forget that. So selective. Typical question. Typical Christian. Selective
question. He doesn't want me to get to this.
Look what kind of stupid question they ask me. Are you still a Muslim? And I say like this. No, what happened after that? I said, I'm joking. Alhamdulillah, I'm a Muslim.
Yeah, but you didn't come back anywhere because I saw you walking away and I was
talking
to
him. I did come back. Don't lie, please. He was there. Didn't I say I'm joking? Didn't I say that last night? Like this, then I say I'm joking. She said you didn't.
Come on. It is as well 50-50.
Yeah, of course. Look, thank you very much for being honest.
Be 50-50. 50?
No, but I 50. Say I'm joking. I say I'm joking.
Yes.
Okay. Right.
Be nice to
so,
us.
No, don't keep talking. How dare you? You're saying I can't ask you a question.
You find the
you can, but after
you, right. You find the reference.
So
and
while I'm finding it, I want you to answer. Why did Isa say, blessed is the day I die and blessed is the day I... Wait, I haven't finished. And blessed is the day I raise again in brackets to life. If he's not a liar in the Quran, if he's the real Jesus who has no life, why would he say that when Allah said he has not died, therefore if he comes back at the end of time and dies, he won't then be resurrected to life because that's Armageddon. Every time I click on that, sorry.
Where is that verse where Elijah went up to the heavens, ascended to the heavens?
He was on the top of a mountain, so I don't know.
He went up to the heavens. He went up to the heavens. I'm just trying to find
it.
I'm not even able to discuss the Bible.
The Bible that Allah says he revealed, the same Jesus that he says is, pure and all of that.
No.
And all liars will burn in a lake of fire. I don't. What are you saying? So you're saying it's a made-up person?
Jesus of the Bible.
So now you're denying Christ fully? Because you blasphemed the Spirit to me last year.
The Bible is a fable.
He's reading the Bible.
It's a fable.
Why are you blaming him?
I'm blaming him because of his mental deficiency in seeing the truth. That's what I'm blaming him for, but I shouldn't because it's not his
fault. Below the belt.
Yeah,
that's what the Christians do.
Which is unforgivable in Christians.
You want me to say something about the Spirit? You want me to repeat it?
You're an absolute
fool.
Do you understand that? You don't need to repeat it. You said it once. It's unforgivable.
Do you have a spirit?
You tried this last time.
Do you have a spirit in you?
Don't do it.
Do you have a spirit in you?
Don't.
Do you have a spirit in you? Because that's how much I believe. This is how strong my belief is. If any spirit tells you the Quran, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is a liar, that spirit is a demon, I'm telling you right now. Okay? I don't deny the Holy Spirit. We believe in the Holy Spirit. We believe it's a Jibreel alayhi salam. We respect him, we honor him. But any spirit that tells you the Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is a false prophet, that spirit is a demon.
And any God that says he's the best of deceivers is not God who has no lies.
Maybe I'll find it. Second Kings, chapter 2, verse 11.
John 3:13 and Elijah and Enoch's account. So this is what I'm reading in the commentary. It says,
Elijah went up into heaven.
Yeah, Second Kings 3:11, Enoch, Genesis.
Are you embarrassed of your Bible? Okay.
Anyway, so, no man ever said, you can stay there then.
Because
who's running away when I'm looking at the camera? Abbas. Seriously, my patience is being tested. No man ever said.
My patience is a lot.
You
I'm
don't
a
want the answer though.
I'm a
right,
Muslim.
Okay. Right, so he doesn't want the answer, but I'm gonna give you the answer because he keeps interrupting the answer because and blaspheming the spirit, which again is really irritating. So
why
has any
away from me?
Why do you not want me to give them the answer? No, seriously, I don't want you near me. No, I want to talk it to camera or nothing. You just blaspheme the spirit through my face. Okay.
I don't understand that.
Right, this is the answer to his verse, which he keeps interrupting and doesn't want me to answer.
Jesus Christ!
So, Jesus' words in John 3:13, and if they contradict the accounts of Elijah in 2 Kings 2:11 and Enoch, which is Genesis 5:24. So, it says, the two verses that I said afterwards clearly say they were taken to heaven. This is the question. When did Jesus say that no man hath ascended into heaven? So here's a short answer, and I can see that I'm not making this up. It says the Bible doesn't contradict itself. Old Testament people did not go directly to heaven when they died. They went to a place called Sheol, which anyone can look up. And it means the abode of the dead. So it's also used sometimes translated as the grave. Sheol was divided into two areas. And this is Jewish, like Joshua, if he was here, would back me up on this. Sheol's divided into two areas. And the Old Testament saints, or those like believers, went to a section referred to as paradise, or Abraham's bosom. And we look back, and that's an argument used for purgatory, which I don't hold to, but it's Sheol. It's not paradise as in the heavens. So the other area of Sheol is hell. So hell and paradise, according to the Old Testament, are two different sections of the same realm of the dead. For unsaved people.
He doesn't
people.
Want to talk to you anymore.
Christian.
Muslim question. You.
I'm a Muslim.
Excellent. I don't have to ask you anything. Seriously, Abbas, I'm not running away. I'm trying. Right, so viewers at the moment. Excellent. Excellent. When you learn some manners, the same applies from me. You do not want an answer, and you've called Jesus a liar and blasphemed the Spirit. You're a wrong'un. You're an...
Jesus not the Bible.
Not me.
Not Jesus. Not
yeah,
Jesus.
Not me.
Jesus according to Bible. According to Bible. I'm here. Answer. You can talk alone. You can answer in front of me.
No. I'm giving my answer to people who
care. So you're answering yourself. You didn't answer me.
No, I'm answering the people.
Because you're checking. I'm going to refute you.
Anyway.
I'm going to refute you. Answer in front of me. You can answer in front of camera.
An answer is a comment section.
I can refute you.
No.
Because I know you are wrong and you're going to be lying.
Sorry. Seriously. Have your empty victory. Yeah. Alice snack bar. Right. Okay, so that's the Jewish teaching of paradise and hell within Sheol, one realm of the dead, which people have actually been referencing Daniel as rising from Sheol, rising from the grave, and therefore we know it's not a heavenly paradise. It's a sectioned off realm of the dead, which is that. So the Christian teaching, as in the New Testament, is that after death, after the death of Christ and the resurrection of Christ, we will now have eternal life. Whether or not you're a Christian who believes in soul sleep, or whether you're a Christian that believes that heaven is attained like instantaneously after death, is another point. So after the death and resurrection of Christ, Christians believe that that's that. And when the judgment comes, you will get either heaven or heaven. So when the Bible says Elijah was taken into heaven by a whirlwind, the Hebrew word shav can refer to the sky, the universe, or to the abode of God. So his body was taken into the sky by the whirlwind, and he was then translated and taken to paradise just like Enoch. He did not go to heaven. Aside from that, the context itself reveals clearly that Jesus was merely stating that no one has divine knowledge from heaven, because no man has ascended unto heaven and returned. That's the key part that Abbas is failing to... I don't want to perpetrate someone repeatedly blaspheming the spirit. I don't want to encourage that kind of behavior and the rudeness, actually. Because before we started filming, like, some pretty arrogant statements. So Jesus talks about ascending. And then because he says, descending from heaven and referencing the Son of Man himself. So divine information carried by a human, like an actual person descending, comes solely in Jesus Christ. So, because no man has gone to heaven and returned to tell anything, only Jesus knew those details. So even if somebody tried to argue that Old Testament saints did go to heaven, which the scriptures indicated anyway that they did not, it still doesn't matter, which is also my point, because Jesus is not a liar. And I could go on actually to the other account, Enoch's account, but I think that kind of wraps it up. And I apologize actually for getting irritated, but Abbas blasphemed the spirit last year right to my face, and it disturbed me for some weeks actually. And I hope and I pray actually that God takes into account mental instability. Like, you know, I hope that he takes these things into account, and it's not cut and dried. If you say it, that's a done deal. And I know that God knows the hearts and minds of men, and therefore, hopefully, I mean, because it's a complete publicity stunt. It's needlessly mocking the Holy Spirit and needlessly insulting the Holy Spirit as like a school ground, like a playground tactic, but like a shock tactic. And I don't want to be a part of it, and I won't be used as a vehicle for anybody to insult the Lord and the Holy Spirit in the guise of an argument, which isn't a very good one anyway. So hopefully that explains it. If you do have any questions, just drop them in the comments section, and come to Discord, the link's in the description. Please pray for Abbas, he certainly needs it, as we've just witnessed, and I will see you all soon. Bye bye.